The first metallic element in group 13 is aluminum. Freshmen and students quite frequently think that this metal is very reactive, given its high negative standard reduction potential. And for that reason, it should be manipulated and kept with caution, like other metals, alkaline reducers with analog potentials, such as sodium. But in contrast, it is difficult to understand how this element is sufficiently stable to actually be used as metal in a large number of everyday applications. Therefore, although the negative value of the electropotential of the reduction could suggest that it will react violently with water, in a similar way what happened in the case of block S metal, that's not the case. As you can see, if we put a piece of aluminum in water, there is no evolution of hydrogen, as we have observed for alkaline and alkaline earth metals. The inertness of aluminum in the presence of water, it is a consequence of the adherent layer of aluminum oxide formed on the surface of the metal. However, it dissolves in dilute mineral acid like hydrochloric acid to form aluminum trichloride and hydrogen gas. If we use oxidizing acids such as nitric acid, it will passivate the metal, avoiding to proceed the reaction. In the case of HCl, the reaction is possible even at room temperature with commercial hydrochloric acid, liberating some hydrogen gas, as you can see from the effervescence form. So now we have aluminum dissolved in the solution, and we increase the pH of the solution by adding some milliliters of 2.0 molar ammonia solution. As you can see, it starts to form a white solid, which is aluminum oxide hydrate. Let's continue adding more ammonia until we neutralize the solution. By simply checking the pH value with some pH strip, we can know when the solution is neutralized. Now we're going to filter off the gelatinous precipitate in a batching funnel placed in a filter flux, which is connected to the vacuum pump. The white solid is then washed with a small amount of water, and we are going to test its amphoteric behavior. Let's put a tiny amount of the oxide in two different test tubes. And now we are going to check its reaction with acid and base. Let's start by adding some volume of dilute hydrochloric acid to the first test tube. As you can see, the solid readily dissolves in acid, showing that it has a basic behavior in its reaction. Let's now to check what happened in the second test tube with a dilute solution of sodium hydroxide. Again, the solid dissolves, showing the acidic behavior of the solid for this reaction. So, aluminum oxide reacts with both acid and bases, which indicates an amphoteric behavior of this compound. Okay, with the obtained aluminum oxide, we are going to prepare a typical compound of aluminum known as alum. What is alum? It is a hydrate double sulfate salts that contain a monopositive cation and a tripositive cation. The compound that gives the name to this family is bisulfate of aluminum and potassium dodecahydrate, which is the only common water-soluble mineral of aluminum. Alums has been used for many years as ingredient of deodorant for its antibacterial properties. It is also known its application for the purification of drinking water, acting as a flocculant, improving the ability to settle the particles. And it's used as blood coagulant to stop minor bleeding events. For this experiment, we are going to prepare a slightly different alum, which contains ammonium cation as the positive ion instead of potassium. So we put the aluminum oxide that we have obtained previously and let dissolve in 40 mL of 2.0 molar solution of sulfuric acid. In order to facilitate the solution of the precipitate, let's heat the mixture and stirring with the glass rod. Once we have a clear solution, let's carefully add 20 mL of 2.0 molar ammonia solution. Maybe some precipitate can appear during the addition, due to the formation of aluminum oxide, but that can be readily dissolved again by adding some drops of sulfuric acid. Finally, let's concentrate the solution up to 50 mL. Now let's allow to cool down the solution in a crystallizer during all night in order to ensure a better crystallization process. Okay, as you can observe, after around 12 hours, a beautiful set of crystals of alum have been formed. Can you advance which could be the pH of this beautiful double salt? Let's see if you are ready to answer that.